Good morning, everybody. Thanks for joining us this morning. I appreciate your attendance. So I'm just going to jump right in. The Chiefs and I agree that public safety is our top priority. Obviously, I'm joined by Chief Mendez and Chief Hutchinson. We have a responsibility to our residents to have top-of-the-line fire and police response by also being responsible stewards of tax dollars. Both announcements today will help the City of Lancaster increase efficiency and maintain our high standard of public safety. If you've heard me speak at a public meeting or a neighborhood event, you likely have heard about the city's financial challenges. We are facing a structural deficit, meaning costs to maintain current city services increase yearly, and our revenue does not naturally increase to meet those needs. And of course, public safety represents 60% of our budget. As a third-class city in Pennsylvania, Lancaster has limited tools to raise revenues and must rely heavily on property taxes. And we face a significant financial cliff when the American Rescue Plan Act funds run out. That is why our city is studying adopting a potential home rule charter, and it is why we are announcing changes with the fire and police bureaus today. Effective January 2024, the City of Lancaster will close Fire Station 6 and discontinue the Police Bureau's mounted unit. The chiefs will agree that these decisions were not made lightly. I want to say that again. These decisions were not made lightly. I recognize that Station 6 and the mounted unit have long traditions of service to the people of Lancaster. Firefighters at Station 6, both past and present, have honored the city with their service, and the mounted police officers have been a positive force for the City of Lancaster for decades. These changes will not impact our staffing levels. I want to say that again very clearly. These changes will not impact our staffing levels. They will remain the same. The change in the police bureau will allow for additional officers in the patrol division where they are needed most. And within the Fire Bureau, this change will improve the safety conditions for firefighters, and Station 6 staff will be redeployed at existing stations. Considering the challenges in front of us, these shifts are needed steps toward operating a sound government that maintains a necessary level of public safety and maximizes public dollars. And at this time, I'll invite Chief Mendez and then Chief Hutchinson to share more details about how this affects their respective bureaus, and then we'll be happy to take some questions. So with that, Chief Mendez.
Thank you, and thanks for coming. Due to staffing challenges and evolving needs of the Lancaster community, the Police Bureau will discontinue the mounted unit effective January of 2024. The three full-time and one part-time officer will be reassigned to the patrol division to assist in call response. The mounted unit has been an asset to the police force, contributing to public safety, crowd management, and community engagement for over 40 years. However, the current staffing challenges have necessitated a shift in operational focus. The City of Lancaster and Bureau of Police expresses its sincere gratitude for the service mounted officers and horses have provided to Lancaster City since 1979. The unit was a leading force in building long-lasting relationships within the community through events, patrolling the downtown investment district, and serving as a friendly representative of the Bureau. Although the Bureau is sad to say goodbye to the mounts, they will make great additions to loving and well-experienced families. The Bureau will work with the Police Foundation, as done with all retired horses, to ensure that Jake, King, and Angus find loving homes. The City and Police Bureau extends its thanks to all Bureau employees, city staff, especially those at Long's Park, the Police Foundation, and community members who have supported the mounted unit over the years. The decision to discontinue the mounted unit was a challenging one. The Bureau understands the sentimental and symbolic value of mounted officers and appreciates the long-lasting relationships they have built. The reality is that Lancaster City's Police Bureau, along with many others, is struggling to fill open positions. The Bureau receives on average 40,000 to 50,000 calls a year for service, and even though the Bureau has quickly responded to the majority of these calls, The additional pressure is weighing heavily on officers already working in high-stress situations. Mounted officers face limitations in responding to calls compared to patrol officers, primarily due to the additional responsibility of caring for the horses. The impacts their availability to attend emergencies and high-priority incidents. Continuing the staff-mounted unit while the four platoons and criminal investigative division faces significant staffing challenges is not viable. Integrating the mounted officers back into platoons will ease the strain on patrol officers and alleviate some financial burden on taxpayers who cover the cost of necessary overtime pay, estimated to be $900,000 in 2023 alone. The Bureau, with the Police Foundation's partnership, continues to explore and invest in new innovative approaches to engage with residents. For example, training more officers to operate bicycles and e-bikes, expanding drone technology, and perhaps adding a therapy dog to the Office of Community Engagement. Discontinuing the mounted unit is a step forward in the Bureau's commitment to better serve the community while responding to the challenges of 21st century policing. The new direction will improve how the Police Bureau serves Lancaster, build even stronger connections with residents, visitors, and business owners, and most importantly, ensures the Bureau is best equipped to respond to emergencies. Thank you, and I'll turn it over to Chief Hutchinson.
Good morning. Thank you, everybody, for coming. With two new state-of-the-art fire stations that meet modern safety standards and the pressing financial strains of the city, the Fire Bureau has decided that Station 6 will close effective January 2024. The Fire Bureau has made tremendous strides in recent years. We've made historic investments of $13.6 million in two new facilities on King Street and $3.2 million in new apparatus. We also have advanced promotions over the last 6 years. A dozen staff have been promoted, building an even stronger bench of leadership that bodes well for the future. And we have onboarded the largest class of new firefighters in the history of the Fire Bureau. Looking ahead, much of the focus is on maintaining investments that we've made in the Bureau's success, especially staffing levels. This will be continue to be a challenge due to the city's structural deficit, as Mayor Cirracci noted. Given our financial constraints at this moment and to prioritize the safety of our firefighters, we have made the difficult decision to close Station 6. Staffing levels will remain the same, and staff stationed at Station 6 will be redeployed to existing stations, and a second aerial purchased in 2019 will be placed into full-time service. This unit will have dual capabilities of both an aerial device and a pump. The resulting configuration will mean that the city is covered 24/7, 365 by four pieces of apparatus, two engines, two aerials, comprised of 67 frontline staff. The Fire Bureau's response times to calls will remain at industry standards. During the construction of the new fire stations on East and West King Street, the city was effectively operating with two fire stations in the city, while one was in Mam Township. This provided an opportunity to assess the response time, specifically in the south of the city. Between 2020 and 2022, the average response time for first alarm reported structure fires in the city met or exceeded the standard set by the National Fire Protection Association. The cost to renovate Station 6 to achieve minimum safety standards was estimated to be between $5.3 and $6.3 million, and these are not updated estimates. Construction costs likely are higher today. The National Fire Protection Association outlines that there must be a clear distinction between firefighter living and kitchen spaces and exposed to where zones are exposed to contaminants or carcinogens. Station 6 does not meet the safety standard, while the two new stations do. Choosing to renovate or build a new station on the site of the current Station 6 will result in additional debt burden and needed tax increases. The Lancaster City Bureau of Fire of today is now reflected in a safer, modern facilities supported by new apparatus and fully dedicated team of professionals who are best in class. We look forward to continuing our high level of service to the community. Thank you.
So we just gave you a lot of information. There will be frequently asked questions and some additional handouts that we'll be providing to you. But at this time, I'm happy to take any questions. Yes.
I'm going to just ask with the mounted police, since 1979, it always seemed like it was a recruitment tool to attract people. What went into that decision, and how much will it save you ending the mounted patrol?
Well, there's a couple layers here. So first of all, I want to give a shout out to the Lancaster Bureau of Police Foundation. The foundation has been a critical partner in providing care for our horses and the purchase of new horses. And we have staff at Long's Park that have been integral into their care as well. So for, I don't want to speak on behalf of the Police Foundation. There is a member of the foundation board that is here today who you can speak to at a later time. But what I want to say is that for the city, the decision to make this change related to the mounted is that we really need those officers on the street. We are facing shortages in our staffing because of a number of retirements that are happening. And we know that nationally it's very difficult to recruit new officers. And so as Chief Mendez indicated, those officers will be moved into the patrol division where they are very much needed. From the city's perspective, there are some cost savings in terms of staff time, but the decision is really about the efficiency and the effectiveness of our response from the Bureau standpoint. So moving those 3.5 officers back into patrol is really needed. Yes, Dan.
How many firefighters are at Station 6, and will they be divided evenly among the other two stations, or how will that work?
There are 12 currently assigned to Station 6. Those 12 will be redeployed and following the collective bargaining agreement between the city and Local 319, of the professional firefighters.
And how many firefighters are there? And you say you've got the largest recruiting class in. I didn't quite catch that.
We onboarded 19 new firefighters in 2022, which is the largest recruit class in the history of the Bureau. And I'm sorry, the second?
How many do you have all together?
Yeah. We have 67 frontline firefighters.
Is that what your complement is?
Yep.
Okay. And for Chief Mendez, what is the city's complement, and what are you down to?
So we are approved for 145. We currently have 115. We know due to retirements, we're probably going to lose within the next 6 to 8 months, 6 to 8 more. And I think a number that's pretty critical is currently right now we have 30 officers that are available, have reached the retirement that they could retire if they chose to. So the numbers are, unfortunately, it was a decision that needed to be made. We need officers on the street.
And what about recruiting efforts, though? You know, are there new ways of trying to get more officers? Can you address that problem right now?
Yes, so we are doing everything imaginable. We hired a firm that has worked with marketing and recruitment. We have a team of 20 officers that are constantly making contacts. If somebody shows interest, they're going to have an officer calling them very often, texting them very often, just keeping them interested. We're looking at, you know, even doing some type of a training for the testing to just keep people interested. So as, you know, we test twice a year. So if we just test in January and somebody shows interest, they have to wait 6 months to our next test. So we're looking at ways to keep them interested for that time. We're bound by civil service. So we are trying everything we can, and we're always open for more options and more help.
You say you're approved for a complement of 145. What are the metrics to determine that number? I mean, could it be less, like a city this size could do with, say, 100 officers, or would you ideally say, you know, a city this size should have 175 or whatever? How's that figured?
So at one point we did have closer to, I believe, 175. I think myself and our staff, our command staff and supervisors, we think 145 is a good number. Right now we're able to maintain it, but the city's we're doing very well in Lancaster City compared to other cities. How long does that hold up? I'm hoping till we can get some staffing, but I think 145 is an appropriate number. But, you know, like the mayor said, and I had said, the patrol officers they're working hard. They're handling a lot of calls every shift, and we just need help, so.
For those large events where you guys use the mounting units and there's a vital part of public safety, do you see yourself, you know, after this unit is gone, bringing in mounting
So I don't see us bringing another mounted. I don't know if the city has such large events like a Philadelphia or something would see that would require that. We are looking at our drone program, which would be key to large events to man that unit. So there are other options. I don't anticipate bringing in mounted.
And for Chief Hutchinson, maybe talk about, you say Fire Station 6, talk about the location. I think it's Fremont Street. The impact on the neighborhood as far as response to fire calls, people living closest to that fire station may have some concerns.
It is located at Fremont Prospect. Our response times have always met or exceeded industry standards, and that will not change with the closure of Station 6.
Has it been there a long time? Or?
It was built in 1957.
I'm not sure if this is for the mayor or for the chief, but the Police Foundation funds, or was buying the horses and paying for at least some of them. Was that fully covered, or did the city still have expenses on top of that? Like, not to look at gift horse in the mouth, but something like that.
The horse puns have already begun. Thank you, Dan. We are contributing the officers' salaries and fringe benefits and all of the costs, personnel costs, for the officers. The Police Foundation was very generous in supporting the needs of the animals, and then the city was also paying for staff at Long's Park that were also participating in the care of the animals.
What will happen to those staff? Will they stay?
The Long's Park staff?
Yeah.
It is my understanding that they will stay. We have plenty of work. There will be decisions that will be made that in terms of the overall scope of their work may shift, but it is my understanding that the folks that are there that may stay. There may very well be other things coming down the road. I will just say that at our last council meeting, or the council meeting before, Director Campbell talked about our street leaf collection, which seems like a small thing, but we have had to deploy our staff in different ways and really need to rely on residents to bag their leaves rather than piling them in the middle of the streets and us having to spend staff resources to go out and collect them. For some of our neighborhoods, they're seeing that as a reduction in service. And for us, we're looking at it as we're already paying for that because it's part of our trash and recycling contract, and we can't add on top of that. So there's a number of things that we are working through in terms of more operating efficiency, looking at our staffing. I anticipate that there will be more changes that are coming. And those conversations will happen in November and December as we roll out the 2024 budget and have our budget hearings, which will be the first Saturday in December. And so, more on that.
Do you see any other changes within public safety?
Not at this time. Yes.
Justin Stubbs, who's One United Lancaster. For those of us who may have been a bit late, it sounds like the mounted police is a major change for the department. Were there other changes talked about at the top of the hour for the police department?
No.
Okay.
Other questions? Yes.
Is the building, the Station 6 building, going to be sold, or is it going to be refurbished?
The building itself, per ordinance that when a property is owned by the city and it is to be sold, it will go through the redevelopment authority. So that property will be transferred to RACL. It will then go through an independent board with its own solicitor to solicit a request for proposals for the use of that site, and it will be sold.
Is it the tip of the iceberg?
We're facing a $6 million deficit beginning in 2025 when the ARPA funds go away. I think it's fair to say we are leaving no stone unturned. Thank you very much for your time today. I appreciate you coming. We have some additional information packets, and again, I appreciate you being here. Have a great day, everyone.